Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Leonbergers are very intelligent dogs. They were bred to be companions. They have to be with their people. They always want to be by your side. My name is Genette Fuller. My husband Danny and I have been involved in Leonbergers since the early 1990s. And we are the breeders behind Leone Leonbergers in San Diego. Leonbergers were developed in Germany. They were originally developed by a gentleman named Herr Essig. He was a pet trader. Leonberg, Germany was a center for pet trade in Europe. And he was outstanding at marketing, and he developed the dog to market a giant breed of dog to honor the town of Leonberg that could be sold to the wealthy throughout Europe. The purpose of the breed was originally to look like the town crest of Leonberg, Germany. It was basically bred to look good, but it is an outstanding companion dog. It was later found out to be a really versatile working dog. It's used for drafting on farms. It's used in water rescue. It's a highly obedient dog. It wants to make its owners happy. There are individuals that would make good guard dogs, but Leonbergers are not known to be guard dogs. They are companion dogs. They're very friendly and happy and energetic. In the early 1990s, we had a bloodhound who died of bone cancer. Our son happens to be disabled, and he had told us after we lost our bloodhound that he would like to get involved in junior handling, which we thought was really an outstanding activity for someone who's disabled and very, very shy. We happened upon a rare breed dog show that was happening in San Diego, and there was a huge group of Leonbergers and their owners at this dog show, and the camaraderie of these people and their beautiful, strikingly handsome dogs drew our attention. And we spent the whole day with that group and decided this must be the breed for us, for our son. And that was when we got our very first Leonberger. Took me many years before I actually bred my very first litter of Leonbergers, which was Grandma is from my first litter of Leonberger. In the 1800s, when Herr Essig was developing the Leonberger breed, it is purported that he used Newfoundlands, Landseer Newfoundlands, St. Bernards, and Great Pyrenees to develop the Leonberger. The problem is Herr Essig didn't keep good records, and we know there must be some other breeds involved in there. Also, the other thing is when you look at Landseer Newfoundlands, Great Pyrenees, and St. Bernards today, they are not necessarily the dogs that he would have used because there were no standards for those breeds back at the time Leonbergers were being developed. So basically it was an individual's interpretation of this giant dog is showing up here, it's in Switzerland, therefore it must be a St. Bernard. We don't know that it's actually the same St. Bernard that we think of today, or the same Newfoundland that we think of today. Leonbergers can range from a blonde color to a lion yellow color to a reddish color to red mahogany red with black tipping. What is common amongst every single Leonberger is they must have a black mask. That's the identifying feature of a Leonberger. Leonbergers are a very versatile breed. They will do anything to make you happy. They excel at obedience, they excel at rally, they excel at agility, they excel at water rescue, they excel at drafting, carting. They are basically an all-purpose dog that if you ask them to do it, they will do it. Living with a Leonberger, they are perpetually under your feet. Living with them, you cannot be fastidious about being a good housekeeper. They are profuse shedders. It's a double-coated breed, and when they blow their coat, they blow their coat big time. We can create brand new dog breeds with the amount of coat that comes out of Leonberger. I'm unfortunate in that I live in Southern California. In our climate, Leonbergers blow their coats completely twice a year and then shed the rest of the year. In other parts of the country where they have colder climates, Leonbergers merely blow their coats twice a year. A Leonberger is a large dog. In males, the height, the preferred height is 30 inches. But it can average from 28 to 31 and a half inches at the withers, but the preferred height is 30 inches. In females, they can range from 25 and a half to 29 and a half, and the preferred height is 27 and a half inches in females. The males that are in good condition generally range about 140 to 150 pounds. And that is one that's at the average of its height. Females that are in good condition, they can range from about 105 to 125 pounds. It is a very freely moving dog. It's very agile on its feet with form following function, and the function being a drafting dog, you would expect it to have quite a bit of muscle mass in the front. It is a, what is it, a single tracking dog? Yeah, it's a single tracking dog. So running along the beach, you would see basically three footprints of the dogs, because you'd see the two front paws and then the rear paws. One would come right down right on top of the other. The other defining feature of Leonbergers, it's one of the few breeds where it is dictated that you have to be able to tell them a difference between the males and females. And a female has to absolutely look like a female, and a male absolutely has to look like a male. The general Leonberger is a very friendly, energetic breed. They are much more active than a Newfoundland. They are busy. They are problem solvers. They are always by your side doing whatever it is that you are doing. And if you're not there for them, they will create their own activities that they feel to be of importance. They can problem, and you may not like it because they're very busy. Leonbergers, like all giant breeds, are faced with quite a few health problems. Cancer runs rampant in the breed. Primarily hemangiosarcoma and osteosarcoma are relatively prevalent in the breed. There are heart problems in the breed. Breeders are very, very diligent about doing as many tests as they can. If science has provided us with a test for health and breeding issues, we will take advantage of it. Hip dysplasia is not as big a problem in Leonbergers. Hip and elbow dysplasia also are not as big a problem in Leonbergers, because breeders have been extra diligent since forever as far as making sure that we're only breeding dogs with the very best hips. Leonbergers are a German breed. The Nazis were particularly proud of anything that was coming from Germany. And so they were very, very diligent about keeping records on all of the Leonbergers that were being bred in the country of Germany. And as a breed club worldwide, we have actually benefited from the record keeping of the Nazis during World War II, coming into World War II and World War II, because we have very, very accurate stud books on Leonbergers, going back to way before World War I.
As a breeder, I'm always looking for a family, that an active family, one that will go to the beach, go to the river, work their dogs, get involved in obedience and rescue, not rescue, obedience and rally, and keeps their dogs busy and active and their mind and bodies active. Training and socialization is crucial to this breed, and you have to do it when they are very, very little puppies because they grow very quickly. And so you want to make sure that you get all of the basic training down before you're dealing with a dog that weighs over 100 pounds. Socialization, my dogs are out, or I encourage everybody to bring their dogs out as often as possible. They are really giant dogs. We want everybody to be really good spokespeople for the Leonberger breed, and the only way to do that is to bring your dog out. It's impossible to get anywhere with a Leonberger. You get stopped constantly, so it's really good socialization. They're a strikingly handsome breed that attracts attention. Leonbergers have to be groomed continually. If you're really, really diligent, they get brushed every single day with my dogs because I'm showing my dogs and I don't like dealing with mats. They get brushed twice a day when they're blowing their coat. If you don't brush them every single day, your house becomes completely covered with dog fur, tumbleweeds of dog fur all over your house. As far as their teeth, I am a raw feeder, and so my dogs, I'm not actually brushing their teeth, but they're getting to gnaw on raw meaty bones, which keeps their teeth clean. When Germany was divided between West Germany and East Germany, breeding was continuing. But the breeders were not really, although they kind of knew what was going on with each other and they would kind of get dogs over the border into East Germany, there were two separate stud books that were being kept. And when the wall came down and Germany was reunified, they combined notes. The East German and the West German breeders combined notes. And what they found was the East German breeders' dogs had much more vitality and better health than the West German breeders' dogs. And what they found when they actually analyzed everything to see what they were doing different on the East German side versus the West German side of the wall was the East German breeders did not have access to commercial kibble. And the West German breeders did have access to commercial kibble. That was the basic difference between the two populations of dogs. And so that was really interesting to find. And the East Germans were primarily feeding raw table scraps, raw food. What I have found, as far as being a raw feeder is, prior to being a raw feeder, my vet bills were running, I have a lot of dogs and they're giant dogs, my vet bills were running about $30,000 to $35,000 a year in vet bills. And since I have started feeding raw, which was about 6 to 7 years ago, my vet bills have dropped to about $3,000 a year. My dogs are much longer lived. My dogs don't have chronic health problems. My dogs don't have sensitivity issues. That's what I am finding is the biggest benefit. And my dogs look glorious. They're healthy and glorious. Today I brought Harper. Her name is Champion Culeone's Bebopalula. Harper is the mother to Wanda June, who I also brought. Wanda June is Champion's Culeone's Call Me the Breeze. And Wanda June is the mother to Rita, the puppy that we brought today. And that is Culeone's Duwa Diddy Diddy. What's wonderful about these three dogs, they are really, really typey Leonbergers. They have wonderful temperaments. They are party girls. They are very reliable. When I take them out, I know that when they go running down the beach, they'll come right back to me. I won't have to be chasing them down the beach. Grandma Harper is a little bit on the chunky side. She's about 135 pounds. Her daughter is Wanda June. Wanda June is a very tall bitch. And Wanda June weighs between 125 to 130 pounds. And she's actually taller than some males. And the baby, Rita, she is just now over 100 pounds. We don't know what size she'll get. She appears to be taking after her grandmother, though. Leonbergers are really great family companions. They're reliable. I really urge you to do research. Breeders are really careful about where they place their puppies. And yeah, come to a dog show and meet some Leonbergers.